The love, peace, grace, and hope of God be with us all. Good morning.
Good morning.
The warm welcome to you all on this Easter morning. Happy Easter to everyone.
Happy Easter.
If you haven't already done so, and you may want to have a wee look around and wave to anyone you haven't already spoken to or wished a happy Easter to this morning. We also welcome all those watching on the live stream and the recording things. Is there a camera here? Yeah, to have a wave to them. In mind of the live streaming, can everyone please take a moment, if you have mobile phones, to turn your mobile phone onto airplane mode. This is just for the live streaming, so that we get as minimal interference as possible. So just, if you do have one, if you hopefully know where the settings are, if you can change it onto airplane mode, that'll be very much appreciated. After this service, you're all welcome to join us for our service in St Peters Kirk at 10:30.
What would you know?
No, you're quite right, not at all. Has everyone managed the airplane mode?
Yes.
Lovely. You'll see on your orders of service there is a responsive call to worship. You're invited to join in the words in bold. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Darkness and death have been overcome. The brilliant light of hope has come. Come, let us worship and celebrate the good news. Alleluia, Christ is risen. We have our first hymn, which is from CH4 410. Let our raises our voices to God with Jesus Christ is risen today. For this hymn, we're going to divide into two groups. You don't totally have to move, but we're going to be sort of divided maybe between Heather, you want to go that way, and that way, whichever, and we'll have the two halves. We're going to be singing in two parts. In the first part of the verse, we've got Jesus Christ is risen today, and then we've got the Alleluia. So for this group on the left, do the first part of the verse, the Jesus Christ is risen today, and then the other half respond with the Alleluia, all through the verse. And then for verse 2, we're going to swap over. Verse 3, we're going to swap back again. And verse 4, swap back over. So everyone should have two shots at the Alleluias and two shots at singing the verses through. So hopefully that is as clear as mud to you all this early in the morning. So we'll see how much holy chaos we can create.
Will you sing with that?
Yes, Jen and I are going to help each group. Thanks, Jess.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Early in the morning, a voice in a graveyard, and footsteps in the dew, showed that Christ had risen, that Christ had come back to those and for those who had forgotten, denied, and abandoned him. Early this Easter morning, in the multicolored company of your church, Lord, on earth and in heaven, we celebrate your creation, Jesus' life. We acknowledge Christ's death and rejoice in his resurrection and your never-ending love. Lord God, open our ears to hear afresh the story of Easter. Open our minds to understand your love. Open our hearts to know your forgiveness. Open our lips to sing your praises. Open our lives to the wonder and joy of Easter. Jesus Christ, we greet you. You meet us risen from the grave. And hear us now as we pray together in the words you taught. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Friends, we're now going to share with you the story from John 20, as you may not have seen it before. My name is Mary Magdalene. The past few days have gone by so quickly. The time had come for the Jewish Passover festival to be celebrated, and my Lord Jesus and his friends had gathered in a room to eat a meal of bread and wine. Jesus spoke to them of how he would be betrayed and denied by them, which shocked his friends. After the meal, Jesus took his friends to the Garden of Gethsemane. Jesus prayed. He was then arrested and taken to the high priest Caiaphas, who early in the morning turned Jesus over to be questioned by Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor. Pilate had Jesus flogged, and the Roman soldiers mocked Jesus, giving him a crown of thorns. The chief priests persuaded the crowd to call for another prisoner, a local rebel, Barabbas, to be released instead of Jesus. The crowd called for Jesus to be crucified. Crucifixion was a horrible way the Romans used to execute people, to make a public example of them. Jesus was crucified and died. One of the religious leaders, a man called Joseph of Arimathea, claimed Jesus' body and wrapped the body in clean linen cloth. Joseph placed the body in his own new tomb he had cut out of the rock. He rolled a big stone in front of the entrance to the tomb and went away. I waited, sitting there opposite the tomb with another Mary for a while. Our Jewish holy day, the Sabbath, begins at sunset on the Friday, so there was nothing anyone could do for the next 24 hours. So we had to wait, and we left. And what a long time that 24 hours was, just waiting. Then, it was the first day of the week, a Sunday, very early. So early it was still dark. I went to the tomb and saw that it had been disturbed. The stone had been removed from the entrance. It had been moved, and the door of the tomb was gaping open. I was so distressed by what I saw, I went running out of the garden, into the city, up the street, until I came to the house where Simon Peter and John were staying. They were friends and disciples of Jesus. I stood a moment to catch my breath, and then I said to Simon Peter and John, "They have taken the Lord Jesus out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him. His body is gone. Where could it be?" Peter and John started for the tomb. Both were running fast. They ran as fast as they could, getting more and more out of breath. John outran Peter and reached the tomb first.
I bent over and looked at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in. I was cautious. I leaned into the tomb to see where the body had been. All I saw were the strips of linen wrappings lying there on the cold slab. The body was gone, but the wrappings were left where they had been. Then my friend Simon Peter, who had been running behind me, arrived. He burst into the tomb. There was no stopping him.
Finally, I caught up with John and I ran into the tomb and saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the burial cloth that had been around Jesus' head. The cloth had been folded up by itself, separate from the linen. Then John came inside. He saw everything I had seen and believed. We still did not understand from our holy text that Jesus had to rise from the dead.
What had made us think something wonderful had happened?
Could it be just because the tomb was empty?
I don't think so.
Was it only because of the remaining grave wrappings?
I don't think so. It was because of both the tomb being empty and the position of the grave wrappings showed us this wasn't a grave robbery. There was no hurried taking of the body for some unknown reason. The grave wrappings were still intact, still coiled where the body had been.
What's going on?
What does it all mean?
It's astonishing.
Let's go back home. Mary, are you coming?
I am going to stay for a while. I stood there weeping, shedding tears of grief, tears of sorrow, tears of confusion. As I wept, I bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked me, "Woman, why are you crying?" I replied, "They have taken my teacher, my Lord Jesus, away, and I don't know where they have put him." Then I turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but I did not realize that it was Jesus.
"Woman, why are you crying? Who is it you're looking for?"
I suppose the man must be the gardener. I didn't recognize him at all. I asked him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." The man simply said,
"Mary."
I turned toward him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher.
"Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet returned to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, I am returning to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God."
I did as Jesus told me to, in search of Jesus' friends and followers. My head was spinning. Should I be walking? Should I be running? Should I take my time and think over the wonder of this wonderful news? I found some of Jesus' close friends and followers and told them the news. I have seen the Lord. And I told them that he had said these things to me. I have seen the Lord, I said. Of all Jesus' followers and friends, of all Jesus' male followers and friends, of all his followers, many who were well known and respected, I was the first to say the words, I have seen him, I have seen Jesus, I have seen the Lord. We join together for our next hymn from Mission Praise 295, I Serve a Risen Saviour. The words are on your orders of service. This hymn may be one that's not known to everyone, maybe not everyone has sung before, so Chris is kindly going to play through the first verse and chorus for us, just to hear how it goes. If anyone does know the hymn, feel free to join in as Chris plays it through once, and then after Chris has let us hear the first verse and chorus, we'll all start from verse one. Thank you, Chris.
I hear
Simon Peter, John, they were just some of the people whose lives changed. They were on a spiritual journey of transformation that first Easter morning. What was it about that morning that affected their transformation? Was it just because the tomb was empty? Was it just because of the grave wrappings folded neatly? As Mary said, no. I would like us to concentrate on some words for a few moments and consider how they may affect us this morning as we each may experience our own spiritual journeys and transformations. It may help to close your eyes for a moment. Do so if you wish. Consider these words. The cross. It is finished. Tomb. Waiting. Darkness. Early morning. Spices and perfume. Stone rolled away. Running. Disciples. Confusion. Amazement. Light. Angels. Mary. Rabboni. Christ is risen. As we consider those words, can we see our own story in the Easter story? None of these characters were changed once and for all or simply overnight. They were all on different journeys from darkness to light. From saved to unsaved, from unsaved to saved. Each were transformed over and over. Mary, when Jesus expelled demons from her, and again when she visited his grave, and again when he spoke her name. John, when Jesus called him from fishing, when he reached the empty tomb, and when he realized that Christ was risen. Peter, being told he would deny Christ, denying Christ. Then he saw the linen cloths. And again, when a forgiving Jesus spoke of love 3 times directly with Peter and instructed Peter to take care of my lambs. Even though we might see some of our strengths and weaknesses in some of the Easter story characters, it is important to remember that when Jesus addressed Mary, he spoke her name. Jesus recognizes us for who we truly are, even when we do not recognize him. Neither are we overlooked or anonymous. We are not just another drop in the ocean. We are prized children of God, and we are cherished to such an extent that no hairs on our head are left unaccounted. How do we recognize other human beings? Do we recognize them as human beings? How is it we can look at a human face and see not just an assortment of skin, hair and bones, but a person too? For most of us, when we see another human being, we see them as human, like us, with hopes, fears and purposes, with valuable lives, as valuable as our own, going through their own journeys and their own transformations. This Easter morning, let each one of us know that Jesus meets us, sometimes in a way we don't often recognize at first. He takes our feelings seriously, whether they are positive or negative. In the hope and light of Easter, the start of new things exist, and Christ speaks to us our name, and he asks us to go and tell other people, tell them of the passion, grace, love, and joy of the risen Christ. And in doing so, we bring the hope of Easter to others. Amen. Jenny is going to share with us a prayer for others. Thank you, Jenny.
Let us pray. Jesus, God who knows our names, we have come here looking for you. Help us to hear your voice. Help us to know your love for us. Help us to find hope and healing with you. And Jesus, we pray for all those whose names and stories are lost, in mass graves, in sea crossings and unsafe boats, in war, in desperate journeys seeking hope. You know their names and you love them all. Open our hearts to care for them too. Jesus, God who knows our tears, we come in uncertain times. Give us courage to keep going. Give us wisdom to find your ways. Give us strength for every step. And Jesus, we pray for all who weep, watching and waiting in illness and death, adjusting and adapting to painful circumstances. You know all tears and you love all who weep and who laugh. Open our hearts to know and to share your love. Jesus, God who loves our world, we have come in the morning, adding our praise to that of the birds, trees and flowers. Show us the wonder of air and sky. Show us the need of sister plants and brother beasts. Show us the oneness of your creation. And Jesus, we pray for your creation, for habitats and species disappearing, for water and land, air and climate in crisis. You know every creature and atom and you love it all. Open our hearts to put your love into action. Jesus, God who loves, hear these and all our prayers, offer trusting in your death-defying love. Amen. And we sing together in 419, Thine be the glory, in 419.
Oh,
Go now with the love, hope and joy of the risen Christ, and the blessing of Almighty God, risen and living Son, and guiding Holy Spirit, be with us all and all whom we love, this day and always. Amen.
Amen.